This is EBSEC's online support program for grade 11 and 12. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum. Today the topic of discussion is subject-verb agreement. In this topic, we will discuss about singular plural subjects and the verb that it follows. So after going through the lesson, the students will be able to learn about singular subject and the verb that follows it, plural subject and the verb that follows. Subject and verb, they must agree with one another in number, like singular or plural. So singular subject takes singular verb and vice versa means plural subject takes plural verb, like the dog chases the cat. And when we turn subject into plural, the dogs, it becomes chase the cat. Now, plural subject and plural verb. Agreement in grammar means that the subject and verb must be alike in number, means singular goes with singular and plural goes with plural. A singular subject requires a singular verb and plural subject is followed by a plural verb. What are the singular verbs? We have singular verbs as is, am, was, does, has. While plural verbs are, were, do, have. I and you require the plural form of the verb, means I or you do not like this article. I, you have enough water. Though they are singular, but we counted them as plural. But I was absent. To accomplish the rules of subject-verb agreement, remember to identify the real subject and determine whether the subject is singular or plural. Now look at the examples. I work hard, singular. I work hard, you work hard, she works hard, he works hard. Salim works hard, the boy works hard. Plural. We work hard, you work hard, they work hard, Salim and Akbar work hard. In singular, plural, both, there are the second sentence, you work hard and you work hard. While in singular, the person is must be one. Okay, there is a singular person over there. So recognizing subject. When a sentence starts with here or there, the subject will always be placed after the verb. Like, there is a problem with this project, there are problems with this project. Here is your book, here are your books. Interrogative sentences, subjects do not always come before the verb. Like, here are the pieces of this puzzle, what is the name of book you are reading? Now rule number one, generally if the subject does not end in an S, then verb will not. If subject ends with an S, then verb will not. Examples: the girl reads a book, the girls read books. Second rule, compound subject joined by an. If there are two or more subjects and they are joined by and, plural verb is used. Hina and Sheena read books. Sugar and egg are needed for the recipe. Rule 3, pronouns as subject, indefinite pronoun as subject. Singular indefinite pronoun takes singular verb. Each has done a good job. Everyone is required to attend the workshop. Plural indefinite pronoun subject take plural verb. Few are doing good. Many are absent today. Some indefinite pronoun may be either singular or plural with uncountable use. Singular with countable use, plural verb. Some of the sugar is on the floor. Sugar is uncountable here. Some of the boys are missing. Rule 4, compound subjects. Compound subject joined by and are always followed by plural verb. Example, a pen and pencil make writing easy. With compound subjects joined by or nor, the verb agrees with the subject nearer to it. Neither the director nor the actors are following the instructions. Neither the actors nor the director is following the instructions. Rule 5. Inverted subjects must agree with the verb. Waiter, there is a fly in my soup. Waiter, there are flies in my soup. How are the relatives taking the bad news? Rule 6. Collective nouns, singular or plural, have verb depending on the meaning. The jury has rewarded him death sentence. The jury members do not agree with each other. Rule 7. Titles of single entities, books, countries, organizations are always singular. Like, The grapes of wrath takes a long time to read. The Burbs is a movie starring Tom Hanks. The Three Musketeers, written by Alexander Dumas. Rule 8. Phrase or clause between the subject and the verb does not change the number of the subject. A theory of physics ascertains that a body in motion stays in motion. The causes of this prevalent disease are still unknown. Rule 8. Phrase or clause between the subject and the verb does not change the number of the subject. Exception cases there. Object of the preposition decides singular or plural verb. When subjects like some, half, more, none, or all are followed by a prepositional phrase, then the object of the preposition determines the form of the verb. Like, all of the soup is left, all of the boys are gone. Rule 9. Pluriform subjects. Pluriform subjects with a singular meaning take a singular verb. Example, mumps is a contagious disease. Politics is an interesting subject. Pluriform subjects with plural meaning take a plural verb. Example, the scissors are on the table. The pair of scissors is on the table. Rule 10. With subject and subjective complement of different number, the verb always agree with the subject. My favorite topic is poems by Longfellow. Poems by Longfellow are my favorite topics. Rule 11. Expressions stating amount of time, money, weight, volume are plural, but they take a singular verb. 4 hours is not enough time. $200 is a lot of money. 4 quarts of oil was required to get the car running. Rule 12. Gerunds and subjects are followed by similar verb. Standing in cold water is a bad idea. Walking is a good exercise. When gerunds are linked by and they take plural verb, what happens? Look at it. Smoking and drinking are injurious to health. Walking and cycling are good for health. Now there is a home task for you. You need to choose the correct answer and then submit it, obviously. If you have any questions, you may ask, but it is advised you to go through the slides again and give it a good practice. Thank you so much.